I was super excited because Chi Modu was an extraordinary photographer, right? I was elated about the front cover because the front cover was just, it was dope.
On April 25th, 1995, Mobb Deep would release their sophomore album entitled The Infamous, an album that would not only rewrite the legacy of their career, but would cement itself in history as one of the foundational and defining sounds of East Coast hip hop. Chi Modu, one of the principal voices of the medium, is responsible for capturing hip-hop artists in the 90s like no one had ever seen them. We sat down to chat with Chi to uncover all the details behind the iconic Infamous cover. This album cover, you know, it's transcended time because of what you were able to bring to the composition of that photo.
Their focus on their art form was no joke, and their loyalty to their crew. You know, like, those things to me really spoke to the character of that group, and I want to be a part of it. It's nuts that you can create something, you know, from this small community in this small part of Queensbridge that goes out to the entire globe. As far as that goes, that's where we could relate to each other, because my pictures do that as well. There are two sessions. There's a studio session and there's a Queensbridge session. Right, so in the studio session, which is what ended up being the main shot on the cover. And basically the structure of the photo was a bit unique for the time. Having Havoc in the foreground, Havoc's dark skin, you know? And remember, the film is super saturated, so I did a cross process. That's why the colors are richer. And so Havoc is darker than P, so P could be towards the back of the frame, because it's a dark background, right?
Right.
And P's features are quite strong, and I remember with that hat, and I remember the bandana, I knew if you rocked his head up a little bit, you'd catch just enough of that bandana on it to be branding. Because remember, for years, he stayed Bandana P, you know? That's his alternate ego, you know?
It was original, just black background, just really just showing who me and Prodigy was.
You rarely see a photo where you're playing with depth of field like that on a group with two artists, where one's tight focus, one's soft focus. Usually that would create some conflict. Actually, how come I'm blurry, how come you're not?
Right.
But in fact, it worked. And to the point where they actually kept repeating that style of picture for years. I had to get them to embrace this kind of new medium and relax and not be afraid of it and trust it to bring out who they are, you know, and bring out who you are in a millisecond, you know, and that's what photography is.
Havoc and Prodigy first met at a knife fight in 1991 outside of Manhattan's School of Art and Design in Midtown. Their more formative years to follow in Queensbridge, shaped by the crack epidemic and abject poverty, would inspire their sound as a group.
Say what you want about how they live. They were still 19, 20, 21, 20, young men trying to find their way in the world. They went through some tough times, really tough times, you know? But, you know, you don't put that on the album cover. But what you can put on the album cover is honesty.
You've talked a bit about in the past about humanizing, you know, the bad kids. Was that kind of your goal in creating this album cover, or was that something that you had consciously in your mind when you were getting these photographs and capturing these moments?
What I try to do with the imagery is get you to actually see the people and not just those people over there. Because I guarantee you, if you look in their eyes, the judgment will fade.
Talk to me a little bit about, for those who don't kind of understand, like, how you were able to capture so much of that, like, Queens energy in these photos.
Queensbridge Park, you could imagine how many hours they've spent on those benches. I mean, hours and hours planning for this music. So my thing is to go back to where it started. And not really with an agenda, but to just show you where it started.
That was like the unwritten rule of meeting up in the morning. You know what I mean? It's like, you know, we on the benches chilling. A lot of that time spent on the benches with me and Prodigy actually translated and converted into songs or topics that we would add inside of songs. It was a really important place.
And I consider myself an honorary member of their crew. You know, because I spend enough time around them, you know, and we're always attached, we're forever attached.
I don't even see the culture without that album, because we kind of shaped a moment in time. You know what I mean? It became a hip-hop anthem. Hip-hop needs anthems.
One of the most iconic hip-hop album covers ever captured. What do you want to leave the audience with when you think about, you know, how important that photograph really is to not only their career and their story, but just in the hip-hop in general?
beauty of the Mobb Deep thing for me is that it's a strong album, it's a strong cover. So they go hand in hand. Because sometimes you can be on a big album and your picture was average. But since it's on a big album, you're claiming this multi-platinum album cover that you shot, but it's like, yeah, but in the photo world, it's not a strong photo, you know? And right. So for me to have a strong photo, what the public thinks is a strong photo on a very, very important album, that's to me is like the perfect combination.